Hey guys, welcome to another video. This is a how-to video on how to make the display stand that was featured in my previous video. I hope you enjoyed my spoof on the infomercials. I had a lot of fun making it, but one thing is I didn't realize all the planning and work that would be required to put all that stuff together. But you know, it was still a lot of fun coming up with ideas for the video, things that would make it interesting, make it funny. So I hope you liked it. As far as this idea for the gun stand, I came up with it when I was driving home from playing paintball. Because you can't really use the cell phone and text anymore. So I was basically daydreaming at a light or something. But anyway, let's get back to the video, the how-to video. Well, as far as the materials, these are the materials that you'll need for the stand. You'll need, for this video, I actually used a half-inch pipe. I have 2 7-inch lengths. I have 2 4-inch, as well as 3 1¼-inch. I also bought 2 caps for the base and 4 elbows for the neck, and a threaded adapter, which I'll explain later. And this is the three-way. Now, I had some difficulty coming or getting this because this was not readily available at the Lowe's or the Home Depot by me. They actually had a different kind of elbow, which is basically the same shape, but it had threads on one end. So I really couldn't use, you know, the half inch right away. But if you decide to use this, you'll have to just buy another threaded male adapter. And that's what is going to be the base for the neck. So you can also use this, get this at your local hardware. But what I actually have is, I found this online. So if you wanna wait a couple of days and order it online, it's basically the same shape, but there are no threads. So basically, all you just need is the half inch tube, and it'll go without any problems. I chose to do it this way because to me it was just a little bit cleaner. It was a little bit more compact, but not much. The beauty about working with PVC is you can basically make your own. You don't have to use this three-way elbow if you don't have to. If you want to use a T-joint, you could do that as well. I already have the half or 1¼-inch things in there. So you can use this for the base. And instead of the 45 degree, use the 90 degree right there. Put the tube right there for the base, and this one for the neck. So depending on how you want the stand to look, you definitely have the freedom to use the parts that you need. So basically for my gun stand, this is the finished product. Let's see. Okay, so you have the 7-inch tubes right here with a cap, the 4-inch right here for the base, and the 2 45s. You have the three-way elbow right here, and as far as the neck, you just use the other 2 45 degrees and the male adapter, which will go into the ASA. Even with the ASA, you have the freedom to be a little bit more fancy. If you have an out of hydro tank or regulator that's busted, you can definitely just take the bonnet out and put the 1¼-inch tube in there. Use the set screws to lock it in tight and basically use it that way. And you can have a semi-fancy gun stand that way as well. Now, if you choose to use this bonnet, one thing that you'll have to do is sand the outside of the tube first to be able to make it fit. Otherwise, it's not going to fit. So just a couple of minutes with the Dremel, or, you know, some work with a Dremel, or just some sandpaper, you'll be able to make it fit. So you can use this as well. Now, another thing that's optional to this gun stand is the use of purple primer. and PVC cement just to make it more durable, more permanent. So you can choose to use that, or if you want to be able to take it apart to make it more portable, that's up to you. So for this video, I'm just going to walk you through the application of the primer and cement as well. Okay, so here we are, ready to apply the primer first. And I'm just going to show you the pieces that I applied it to. So I'm going to apply it for the caps, which again is optional. I just wanted to make it a little bit more permanent. So I'm just slightly coating the inside. Now I'm also going to coat both ends of the 4-inch tubes. I'm going to start with the base first, and then the 7-inch. Well, for the 7-inch, I chose to just, well, actually, I'm going to do both. And two of the 45s. So now with that aside, this is the three-way elbow. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to coat all three joints as well. Right there. And the 1¼ pieces. Just to get it all done in one shot so I don't have to break up the assembly. Now, one thing you have to watch out for if you do use the PVC cement and the primer, especially for the base, is before it sets, you have to make sure it's nice and even, otherwise you'll have a lopsided stand. And I'll do the 45s. Now, for the 140, the last 45, I'm only going to coat one side. This is where the, the threaded adapter or your bonnet is going to be. It's important not to put PVC cement, just to be able to take it out, thread this into your gun's ASA, and put it back. It makes it a lot easier to have to put it on and take it out. And if you, with this design, you can't really wrap it around, especially if you use PVC cement, you can't really take it off, so that'll be useless. So, like I said before, let's get started with the base. All right, let me put these aside. So, we will take the two 45s. And now I have the PVC cement right here. This is a little bit thicker, so I'm just trying to take a little bit off the applicator right now. I'm going to coat both of the inside. As well as the caps. So now, taking the smaller, the 4-inch, no, actually no, I'm sorry, take the 7, and if you want to a cleaner look, take note of where the letterings are, and point it to the bottom. So when you assemble, all the letters will be on the bottom, so the display will just show the non-marked side. But for the cap, it doesn't really matter. All right. So, next one. Like I said before, take note of the markings if you want a cleaner look. So I'll have it right there. For one leg of the base. And so it's going to look like this. So this is going to be the bottom, and this is the bottom. Push it in, and you're ready to go. Right there. And then you're going to take the 4-inch, and I'm just going to look at the bottom. With these pieces, you don't really have to worry about it being level right now. It's not until you get to the elbow right here. All right. So what I'm going to do now is put some cement on just two. And to make sure that it's level, I'm just going to move this out of the way. Put this here. Okay, so now this sets really quickly. So what I'm going to do first is just slightly put it in there and check to see if it's level, and then push it a little bit more. Make sure I have time to adjust it
so that it's level.
So here we go.
Double check again
and push it down. Like I said, you have to be very careful because you have a limited amount of time to make sure that it's level. So so before you push it in all the way, make sure it's level. So here we go. So now that one's done. I'm going to put it back over here. And let's get started with the neck. Okay, the PVC again. Take one and a quarter joints and put it in there. And now the elbow. Alright, so this is the one that has both. So I'm going to apply it right there. Now I'm actually going to put this aside for now and apply it to the elbows right now. All right, take one of the joints, put it in, and I'm just going to line up the two marked sides and push them in, try to align them too. So there we go. So this is the neck part. And now, just want to make sure that it's going to be in the middle. That's why I assembled the neck first. So the same like before. Make sure it's nice and straight before you push it all the way in. And that's about right. There we go. So now you basically just take the threaded adapter. It's up to you. You can either put the primer and the cement in this side or the threaded adapter, as long as you don't put it on both. So this will give you the ability to disassemble it, put in the ASA, and and display it. So, whoa, that's one thing I forgot. Putting it in the threaded adapter. Gotta make sure I don't have too much. So here we go. And just put it in. And here we go, you're all set. So here is your homemade gun stand, which didn't really take long to assemble at all. I hope you found this interesting and gave you some ideas to make your own. You can definitely use this design or come up with your own. Like I said, you can use the T elbow and the 90 degree elbows if you want, or you know, if you, like I said before, if you had a busted regulator or an old regulator just laying around and can't really hydro or recertify the aluminum tank, you could definitely use one of these. Now here is another variation of the stand that I just made. This is shorter, more compact. As you can see, I took out the other longer legs and I put the cap on the shorter tube, and I took out the other 45 degree elbow. So this one actually displays the gun at more of an angle, a 45 degree angle. So it's a little bit more compact. You can actually even take it to the field with you if you want, or if you have a large area to display it, or you have a large amount of gun, instead of having it at a parallel level to the shelf or the ground, you can actually have it in a 45 degree angle and display more markers or more guns in your man cave or your shelf and whatnot. Well, all right, guys, that about does it for this video. I hope you found this video interesting and maybe even encouraged you to make your own display gun stand for your markers. Feel free to make comments to see how it turned out for you. I hope everything turned out okay, wasn't too much of a trouble to try and get and put together. But also, thank you for watching the spoof clip that I just made. I enjoyed making it, and I hope you really enjoyed it. So like always, feel free to comment or give me any advice. But also, don't forget to subscribe and like the videos. Thank you again.